Hi Mahendra.
Yeah, hi sir.
So, when we assigned your competency on Windows Server 2016 and working with containers on that, what was your experience on it?
My experience was really great. Even before started working on Windows Server 2016 and containers on Server 2016, I spent approximately 1 year on containers and Linux.
That's it.
And at that time, I was under impression or I was under misconception that when you talk about Docker and container, then everything revolves around Linux. Oh. There is Linux, Linux, Linux everywhere.
Okay.
So it was like, it was a kind of a myth buster for me. I started exploring more of Windows Server 2016 and Server Container, and then I got to know that there is not just one single isolation level that is available there. There are actually two different isolation levels, like Hyper-V container and Native container.
Okay. Okay.
Then when I started digging it up further, I find it out that Windows and Microsoft has really made a very good combination of, you know, their server product and the container platform. Let it be the community edition of Docker or enterprise edition of Docker. And you know, you can pack different kind of application. It is not just limited to the .NET application only.
So do you say we can host a non-Microsoft application within a container which is hosted on Windows platform?
Yeah, that's fine. That's right. Because, you know, most of the non-Microsoft product, like for example, if you talk about open source product, it is as easy as deploying let's say open source application stack on Linux container. It is equally easier to deploy it on Windows container.
That's right.
What basically changes is just your base image. Instead of using the Linux base image, you might be using a Windows base image. And to make it further possible, it is also possible to, you know, run your Linux container on Windows via a small Hyper-V Linux machine.
Oh, that's right.
So this makes it possible to, you know, deploy that kind of workload also, which is, anyway, it is not recommended to do that, because there is a one more layer of abstraction where you will be actually connecting to a Linux virtual machine, a Hyper-V virtual machine, more with Linux, and all your Docker containers will be actually deployed inside it.
Okay.
But anyway, it does provide you a very good compatibility with Linux container on Windows.
How about real-world applications? So do you see, going ahead, industry will go and adopt these kind of things?
See, industry has already started adopting containers. If you talk about Linux container, the adoption is almost finished. It is almost a mature product.
Okay.
When it comes to Windows, it is now picking up pace. Now, what Microsoft has done is they have provided two different base images for us to work with, the Nano Server image and the Server Core image. And the Nano Server image is extremely reduced, or you can say the compressed image, with just less than 2 GB of image size.
It provides you the... Why is Nano?
Yes, yes. Yeah, and it provides you the complete operating system. Obviously, there are a few things, there are a few limitations over there, like you cannot run MSI executors, etc. But if you really want to deploy, let's say, some kind of open source project where you might be using something like Python or something, you know, it's better to use that particular image.
That's it.
Most of the services, Windows related services, may be absent over there, but the base operating system is still available to you. You can just install additional runtime environment, put your application into it, and then deploy it.
Great. So it was great talking to you.
Thanks. Thank you very much.